greatest reward imaginable. Tonight, after a long layoff and a resurrected career, Henry Tillman's path to greatness once again leads through Mike Tyson, now the former heavyweight champion. For Henry Tillman to score a hat trick, he'll need to step out of the shadows of anonymity, just like he did in 1984. Now the Olympic heavyweight gold medalist prepares to enter the ring. You see there his professional record, 24 fights. Included in those 5 years, one 20-month layoff from the sport. Maybe the neatest and most compact phrase I've heard to size up Henry Tillman was issued by the outstanding ABC Sports boxing expert Alex Wallow, who said of Tillman, he has the heart of a warrior, but not the chin of one.
Too brave for his own good and his own body.
Of course, that statement was made about Tillman at a time when he was fighting as a cruiserweight at 190 pounds. He claims that he is much more resilient and steadier now as a 215-pound heavyweight.
Similar about to relive those two amateur losses he gave Mike Tyson, trying to relive those moments of glory.
He's a sweet man who's made something of his life from terrible beginnings, but I'm afraid for this night he's just a frog being fed to a snake.
Well, on the bright side, he believes, Larry, that he wrote the blueprint for beating Mike Tyson with his two amateur victories over him, and that Douglas merely stole a page from the script with his Tokyo exploit.
A lot of people knew the blueprint, having seen those fights, but even forgetting the fact that Mike Tyson is a whole lot different fighter than he was as an amateur, it was only Douglas who could execute the blueprint.
In 24 fights, Tillman has won 20 times, lost 4. He's had 14 knockouts of his own. You heard him say in the profile that he has not been knocked out, but he has indeed been the victim of technical knockouts by journeyman fighters like Dwayne Bonds, in addition to outstanding ones like Evander Holyfield. What must Henry Tillman do against Tyson? What must Tyson do to begin regaining his glory? Ray Leonard's tip of the night.
Well, when Mike Tyson bobs and weaves, he becomes an illusion. That upper body movement allows him to slip, get inside, and to attack his opponents with those devastating combinations. Speed, combinations of power is synonymous with Mike Tyson. He must get mean, get aggressive, stay on top of his opponents. Now with Henry Tillman, Tillman needs to box, get inside, throw his punches, and get outside. Stay out of harm's reach. Don't fight Mike Tyson. That's a mistake so many guys have made other than Buster Douglas, who's successful. Don't fight him, box him. Use that ring as much as you possibly can, and you should be able to turn the tables around.
And now you see the Tyson entourage beginning to emerge from his dressing room. One of the new faces there, just behind Tyson, just out of the shot to camera right, is Rich Giacchetti, the longtime trainer of Larry Holmes. Tyson's reign of terror over the heavyweight division lasted 3 years and 3 months until February 10 stateside, February 11 in Tokyo, when Douglas took the title away.
Care business tonight.
Can't read Tyson's mind here. He doesn't seem quite the eager, intense fellow that he was as a young man, and I guess he shouldn't be. He's not 18, 19, 20 years old anymore, but I think I see a more mature Tyson who wants to take care of whatever business he has tonight.
There are some who say, incidentally, that the left eye has never fully mended from the beating it took from Douglas in Tokyo. And as you look at that close-up shot, you can see what appears to be some discoloration under the left eye and some puffiness around the outside of it. Now, Ray Leonard, 4 months have passed. Is it possible that eye hasn't fully healed from what Buster Douglas did with it?
He's had adequate time for that to heal and get back to normal. But I'm sure it depends on the type of training he went through, the type of sparring he went through that made that possible again, the swelling.
And there are a lot of question marks about that because writers and reporters were not allowed access to Tyson's training session to anywhere near the degree that has been customary before big fights like this in the past.
The real challenge for Mike Tyson will come when some big, strong heavyweight comes along who can fold him up in his arms and try to do the things that Douglas did to him. Then we'll find out whether he wants to be a champion of the 90s as well as he was for a brief time in the 80s.
Mike Tyson's record, 37 wins, one loss, 33 knockouts. He started his career with the 19 consecutive knockouts before James Tillis and Mitch Green solved the mystery of how to go 12 full rounds with Tyson. Later, Bone Crusher Smith and Tony Tucker did the same thing. But other than that, it's been all knockouts. Mostly his, the one by Douglas. There's a look at Rich Giacchetti.
Yes, that's the new executive trainer in charge of the team. He was really imposed on Tyson. Tyson didn't want him, but finally he agreed to accept him. And there is Eddie Aliano, the new cut man, known as Eddie the Clot Aliano. And, of course, that infamous corner treatment that he got in Tokyo, Tyson, this man won't let anything like that happen again.
Tail of the tape for Tyson versus Tillman. You can see that Tillman is much the senior of the two and the taller. Tyson weighing in at 217, and he looked very thin for Mike. Smaller in the eyes of many than was the case at 221 or 222. 71 inches reach as opposed to the 81 inches for the much taller Henry Tillman.
And our punch stat numbers. Interesting numbers there on what Tyson did in his 10 previous title fights, the activity he had. A quick reading of that might tell you, well, Mike Tyson wasn't the same against Buster Douglas. My reading of it is that Buster Douglas didn't let him throw as many punches. He kept him busy defending Buster Douglas's punches. In any event, there you see Tillman's activity in the two fights that he lost against Holyfield and Cooper, and you can see he throws a lot of punches, doesn't land a lot because he's fleeing as he throws. And there you see the jabs. Tillman will have to throw a lot of jabs. But the plain truth is he doesn't have anything to worry Tyson about.
Nevada rules again. Three judges scoring on the 10-point must. And once again, the most important rule, if one of the fighters goes down three times in a round, the fight is over. Let's go back up to Chuck Hull.
Ladies and gentlemen, the officials are signed for the next bout of the evening by the Nevada State Athletic Commission. The judges will be Chuck Ciampa, Art Lurie, and Dolby Shirley. Your referee is Richard Steele. The next bout of the evening, a co-main event of the night, featuring 10 rounds of boxing in the heavyweight division. Introducing, in the blue corner, fighting out of Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 215 pounds, with a professional record of 20 wins, 4 defeats with 14 KOs, he was a gold medalist in the 23rd Olympiad in Los Angeles, California. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Henry Tillman. And in the red corner, from Catskill, New York, weighing 217 pounds. His professional record consists of 37 wins, one defeat, with 33 KOs. He is a former undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, Iron Mike Tyson.
Mike Tyson is a 1-2 favorite to knock out his opponent in the first round. That means if you wanted to make $2, you have to bet $4. The over-under is 2.5 rounds, the lowest I've ever heard of. That means you can bet on whether the fight goes past 2.5 rounds or less than 2.5 rounds here in Las Vegas.
And given the choice of opponents, you have to believe that what the Tyson camp dearly wants for their fighter is one of those 90-second knockouts on which his destroyer reputation was built.
You see what's happening here with Henry Tillman, using the ring, using movement. Mike Tyson, I knew he would charge right at Henry Tillman because he doesn't respect Henry Tillman. But in doing so, he may leave himself open because he's trying so hard to impress. You see the right hand by Henry Tillman. Mike Tyson must be aggressive, but he must be careful, not a rushing him.
Now, question, how much does that remind Tyson of the overhead right that Buster Douglas kept stuffing into his mouth in Tokyo?
Great. Never
every time that Tillman lands a punch, it reminds him, it brings back that memory.
Mike Tyson is a man with conviction. He wants to be impressed.
Right,
he wants to impress not only himself, but to the prince and say, Mike Tyson's beaten soundly by Buster Douglas.
Punching it out now.
All right, great. Dillon's idea, move, box, jab, fast combinations, give Tyson angles. All very well and good. What happens when he gets hit?
The right hand of Tillman needs to be close to that chin. He knows when he drops it. Pretty often he drops it. Now, he's doing the right thing, Tillman is. When he touch comes inside, if he's not going to punch, tie him up. Break his rhythm.
Solid right hand by Tyson to the body. Tillman staggers backward. Mike goes at him and Tillman grabs and holds on.
Right.
Because he's trying to time Mike Tyson's onslaught. Not that much movement from Tillman.
Tillman missed with an overhand right. Trying exactly as you said he would to drop it in.
He should be doing a lot more movement than he is now. He's allowing Mike Tyson to trap him in the corner. Seconds. I think it went over.
Yeah, I think there are a lot of people who are probably surprised by how far it went. Henry Tillman is not known to take a punch very well. He took one really solid blow earlier in the round, and the vicious shot to the body, and finally it was that right to the forehead that was enough.
The question I have as we watch this again, and there is the punch. A high punch on the forehead, the same sort of a punch that knocked out Trevor Burbick when Mike Tyson won the heavyweight championship. The question I have is whether you can sell another doubleheader like this with a combined 6 or 7 minutes of fighting.
Well, if it's Francesco Damiani and Alex Stewart, as appears to be the case in September, those are fighters with better credentials than those of Adelson Rodriguez and Henry Tillman.
This is true, but I'm just curious. I don't know whether you can. I'm not saying you can't sell it. I'm just asking whether you can. We came here for a two-ring circus, and we got it.
One more look at the Hail Mary right hand. I know I'm going to land it somewhere here. And Tillman never responded at all to Richard Steele's count. And now let's go up to Chuck Hull for the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time, 2:47 of the first round. The winner by a knockout, Iron Mike Tyson.
So, referee Richard Steele raises the hand of Mike Tyson. There's Rich Giacchetti. A very successful debut for Rich Giacchetti. And here you see the total punches in the round. Tillman landed 4, Tyson 14, according to our statisticians. Not that it makes any difference. If there was any doubt going into this fight, and there wasn't,
Tillman landed a hard, clean right on the button of Tyson. Early in the round, Tyson barely blinked. There's the big crowd standing around. It's been a curious crowd. I think the crowd knew what it was coming for, which was a show, a circus, as we've been calling it. There wasn't a lot of high excitement about it, just a lot of high curiosity to see two former champions performing. Go through it one more time. Left jab, bang, right over the right jab. Perfect shot by Mike Tyson. Once again, Henry Tillman, too brave for his chin. Now to you, Jim.
All right, Mike Tyson has joined us now at ringside. Mike, a lot of people thought that maybe you had some questions to answer for yourself tonight. Were there questions in your mind, and if so, did you answer them?
No, I didn't have much doubt on the outcome of the fight. It's just that I was skeptical because I didn't give my best performance. You know what I mean? I had no idea that. I knew I was always the same person still. It's just that I was reluctant in the situation, and I wasn't professional, and that's not characteristic of me.
How good did this performance feel for you?
Well, it helps, you know, you come back, you got your win. It helps the confidence. But I want to fight often as I possibly can.